Morning, everyone. I see we still have some people coming in. There's a lot more empty seats on that side, but you can squeeze over there. Let's see. We don't have time to give everyone a chance to introduce themselves, but I'll provide some statistics on who's here. Again, we have a record. This data is a bit unreliable, but 420 was the number last night, I think, and then Alice added a few and took away a few. But we should be more than 400 people together this week, which is pretty exciting, from 74 different countries and 152 unique organizations. So it will be a blast. Warm welcome to everyone. We also have a lot of people online, more than 800 in addition to the 400 that's here. So where are you from? I mean, this. When you registered, you saw that the form was a little bit ambiguous, and I saw that there were some opportunities to change a bit the country of residence versus the country where you were born. I think this is a bit of a mix, but it shows a lot of diversity anyway. We have countries all over the world, from west to east, from south to north. A lot of countries from Africa, as you can see. And there's also some countries that you can't see. We have many participants from the Caribbean this year, with a big team from CARFA, the Caribbean Public Health Agency, as well as country representatives from St. Lucia, Dominica, Grenada, and St. Vincent and the Grenadines. They're up there, but you can't really see them. There's no color on the map. But warm welcome to you. And I think this reflects the great new interest for DJI Studio in the Caribbean. And through the MOU with CARFA, UIO really looks forward to helping you strengthen support for DJI Studio in the region. Then I also want to give a special mention to the two people traveling from this part. Imagine traveling all the way from this bottom right corner all the way up to Norway there. That's the M Supply team. Warm welcome to Craig and Dania. And then some more statistics. You can see on the left, these are the country delegations. Of course, we have a big group of Norwegians here, as well as Americans. I think these Americans work all over the world, so they come from many different organizations, including our own. There's also a big team from Ethiopia, 26. So if VFS accepted all those visa applications, there will be a big team from Ethiopia, from the ministry here. Zambia, UK, Mozambique, Spain, Uganda, Malawi. You see, there are many, many big teams across Africa and Europe coming, also from Pakistan there. And then on the pie chart, you can see that it's a very nice mix of organizations that we work for, both for country governments, NGOs, international organizations, quite a few from academia, also beyond the University of Oslo, and then 51 participants from different private companies as well. So a great, great mix. Then, of course, a special welcome to all the country government representatives. As always, many ministries of health are here. We also have Ministry of Education, and new this year, also National Met Services, reflecting the new work on climate and health. And, of course, this is what this conference is all about, countries sharing experiences with DJI Studio and their implementations. So let's take some extra time and introduce these teams. I'll call the countries one by one, and then you can stand up and wave, and we'll clap for you. I can't promise that all these got their visas, and I saw there were some badges still outside, so, but let's see. Let's start with a team from Angola. Anyone from Angola here? In the back, welcome. They just arrived, yeah. Do we have a team from Bangladesh? Minister of Health, Bangladesh. Are you in the room? Not yet. Okay. Chad? Yes, welcome. Dominica? Is there anyone from Dominica here? The Caribbean delegation? No, not yet. Eswatini? Should be Minister of Education here. Yes, welcome. We'll hear a lot more from Eswatini on Wednesday. Ethiopia, how many of the 26 made it? Not all. Welcome. Yeah, if you're coming in now, there are many more empty seats on that side. And then the Gambia. Anyone from the Gambia? I can't see anyone. Then Ghana. I saw some outside in the back. Welcome. Grenada. Anyone from Grenada? Looks like the Caribbeans haven't arrived yet. Guinea, welcome. And Kenya. Welcome, Anya. Laos, I think we should have, from the Met Services, welcome. And Libya. Anyone from Libya? Not arrived yet. Malawi, I think you have a big team here. Welcome. Maldives. Mozambique. Anyone from Mozambique? There, big team. Warm welcome. And then Nigeria. That was also a big delegation. Welcome, Aluka. Pakistan, always a big team here. In the back there, welcome. I think for the ones that just come in, no problem. There are a lot of seats on this side. You can walk down here and up on that side, I think it's here. Then see, Paraguay. Anyone from Paraguay? No. Rwanda. Rwanda is there. Welcome. St. Lucia. Yes. Welcome. St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Are they here? Not yet. Senegal. Welcome. Somalia. Yes, please stand up. South Sudan. Yes, welcome. We'll hear more from the South Sudan Ministry of Health tomorrow morning. Sri Lanka, welcome. Tanzania. Yes, welcome. And Togo. Welcome. Trinidad and Tobago, so that we can include the CARFA team. Welcome. And Uganda. Welcome. Zambia. In the back there. And Zimbabwe. Welcome. Great, and I hope the ones that were not here will arrive later in the day. Okay, and then if we remove all the country government teams and also the HISP groups, these are the biggest organizations or delegations from organizations this year. So you can see FHI 360 has a very big team here. Can you all stand up? FHI 360 from all over the world, welcome. And then I did merge all the country offices, regional and global teams here. So this is for WHO from all over the world. Welcome to you. And there are also many from US CDC, from countries and Atlanta as well. Welcome to you all. And a big team from PATH and Digital Square. Welcome. And UNICEF, again, many from countries and headquarters. Welcome. And there's quite a big team from Simprints as well. Are you here? Simprints in the back. Welcome. And then CARFA, the Caribbean Public Health Agency. Have you arrived now? Yes, in the back there. Welcome. And Doctors Without Borders, MSF, also has many different organizations here. Welcome to you all. Mercy Corps from Pakistan, are you here? Not yet. And then BO Systems, welcome, welcome Busoye, welcome. And Chai, welcome. And there's quite a big team from Pokhara University in Nepal. Are you here? Yes, welcome. And then Zimtech from Zimbabwe. Are you here? Yes, welcome. Samaritan's Purse. Yes, welcome, welcome. And ICF. Warm welcome. And Apps Associates. Okay, we do you say next. Apps. Anyone from Apps? Welcome. And USAID, I think this is also a mix of countries and headquarters. Welcome. Great. And then we have more than 20 HISP groups here. So let's all stand up, all the HISP groups in the room. Warm welcome to you all. Thank you so much. Now we got a bit of exercise in the morning as well. So this is the last slide before I hand over to Kristin. So if you want to know more about the participants, you can browse the director of attendees here. You'll have, and you can also add your own profile, your photo, etc. And then, of course, take the opportunity in all the coffee breaks, lunch, etc., and network. There will be a lot of opportunities to socialize during the week. So warm welcome to all of you, and I hand it over to the director of the HISP Center, Kristin Brå. Thank you so much. Are they here? Okay. So we got some new data entry, and we have to run analytics. And now we have also Minister of Health Burundi in the room. Are you here? Burundi, bienvenue. Yeah. Hope there were no other countries we forgot.
Burundi didn't mention.
He said no.
There was one more. Burundi, yes, I mentioned Burundi. Any other countries?
South Korea.
South Korea, welcome. Great to see you all here. Okay.
DRC also? Do you forgot DRC?
DRC, Minister of Health, DRC, welcome.
Are there more people that we've forgotten?
Expertise France, yes. We didn't. There were 152 organizations, so we only listed the biggest ones, but you're all very welcome to Oslo this week. Thank you.
Senegal was on the list, I think.
Yeah, Senegal was there. Okay. We can clap. I feel that this sound is very loud. Am I very loud? Okay. It's not showing, but maybe it will. Ah, okay. So happy to meet all of you. I think we will have a lot, plenty of time to get to be really know each other during these four busy days. We are breaking all record, as Ola said, not yet in the room. However, you look like you are much more people than we are used to. We need to remember it started very small with this annual conference. At that time, it's called Expert Academy. And then the Use Case Bazaar was in my garden. So we have grown quite a lot during these years. We haven't had this annual conference for 30 years, but however, it's all started 30 years ago. So this year we will really dwell on this 30 years anniversary by having this party, as we said, but it's also very much looking back to what we have achieved. Why are we here that we have so many ministries represented? 77 national health information systems are in use. So many NGOs are using DSS2 for the benefit, for the global good, and we are developing new sectors, new areas as we speak. So we are dwelling also on these kind of theoretical concepts. What do we do together in order to address digitalization for the global good, for the government in the global south? The global north can learn a bit here and there as well, and they are starting to do that. However, our focus will always be on the global south. And today, this is just the soft intro, the soft opening. The hard opening will happen a little bit just after what's new in DHS2, with our State Secretary for Development coming here and doing the real opening. This is just a homey domestic opening from the HISP Center, but the real one will come from the State Minister of the Development, because NORAD has been supporting us since 1994, as supporting the project in South Africa, reconstructing as part of the reconstructing of health sector after apartheid. And they are still supporting us. And this year, on Friday, we signed a 5 years agreement contract with NORAD for the first time. We usually have 1 year, 3 years, and you know, renewing all the time. But this year we have 5 years. 5 years where NORAD are supporting our strategy. So not to overlook the other investors of the platform, as DHS2 and the HISP network has grown to be, but NORAD has been very, very instrumental and important to us, because they are always trusting the good working countries, are the flexible funds wherever we need capacity building. And we all know it's all about people, even though you all are eager to hear the next sessions, which is what's new in DHS2. However, it's all about the people who are represented in all these countries that we have mentioned, supported by all these HISP groups. It's all about the capacity we are able to bring to the table in the government and in the countries. And that is where the NORAD, but also the University of Oslo, that who are hosting us as a center. And you know that we are a center now, not kind of a deep down a section inside the Department of Informatics, but we are a center that are growing and also getting a lot of attention now also in Norway. However, we are always looking for new opportunities. Last year we talked a lot about education, but this year we also talk about the new grant we got. We talked about it last year, but it happened this year. We have gotten into a new area, which is called, where we are looking for how can we enable countries with data to be prepared for climate change? What are the climate-sensitive diseases that can improve their decision-making in order to be prepared, predict, or even just understand the impact of climate change on diseases? So that grant, we got announcement on during the COP28 in December, however, from Wellcome Trust. However, the grant was only coming in 1st of March, and we have worked very hard since then. Because what is DHS2 about? It's about, we have also, the HISP network is growing. We have now, look at this beautiful picture, starting with the first HISP, not ending with the last one, because the last one is HISP Ghana. But since we met last year, we have had HISP Mali, HISP DRC, HISP MENA, HISP Cote d'Ivoire, and then HISP Ghana. So a big hand for the new HISP groups that actually, almost all of them are in the room, except of Cote d'Ivoire. So we are growing also when it comes to a network. And we need to grow, because, of course, the tasks are many, because what I'm saying, we are going cross-sector. And DHS2 is about turning the platform, learning from the pandemic. All the best we did during the pandemic was actually to see how that DHS2 platform could be a platform for innovation. Innovation in the fringes. Innovation that could be shared. innovation that actually can address use cases in countries, but also shared and domesticated to other countries. So that kind of innovation sharing and the innovation happening out in the countries, that is super important. And what shall the platform do then? So what we have done this year, working hard, started actually exactly 1 year ago during a HISP gathering. We were talking about how can DHS do, as a platform, support schools, school management, teacher attendance, which is super important to get the teacher to attend the school, huh? Not only the pupils, pupil attendance. How can we do all this functionality in order to track teachers and track pupils' education, performance, logistics, etc.? That is hard for our platform because then we have to invest a lot in the core. So we decided 1 year ago to build an app. An app that should be so solid that it can actually address the full stack use cases that is needed on the school level, the pupil level, the teacher level. However, not customized only for one case that we will hear about Eswatini, we'll talk about it on Wednesday, but also supporting all the other countries in the way we are normally doing in DHS2, customizing to the domestic need in the country. In the same time as it can be maintained. Not that it's a custom app that can will break the next release. So this is calling for something that is super important for us that we now talk about as extensibility. We have done the same, but I just want to add one more because it's related to the HISP network. Because this design of this app was done across all the HISP groups that were supporting education use cases across the continents. Not only in West Africa and East Africa, but also in Asia, in Sri Lanka. So everyone worked together in order to be able to crack that solid use case and test and use all the effort in order to make a very, very useful SEMIS app, we call it. People think that's a very stupid name, but it's still SEMIS app. But this app is very powerful. So learning from this one, we can do things fast. We felt it was super fast because it was developing a couple of months during the summer. We also did the same with we, as in Bjorn, as in our GIS team, did the same when it came to climate health. We were thinking, this is a new area for us. We don't know anything about climate data, not much, not more than others, about, you know, data, climate data. How can we actually learn what kind of impact climate data can have on diseases? So what we did was actually to develop an app again, extensibility, to develop an app that can be, that can use satellite data. Oh, then we're thinking satellite data, that's maybe not very localized. But these are the satellite data that is in Copernicus, the ERA 5 data set, which is actually the data that are reported through WMO from countries, vetted, validated with the satellite data, and then we are getting it through the Google Earth engine into the DHS2, and then we can see visualizations in the same picture with looking through the last 30 years of weather, the seasonality, compared to the malaria cases, for instance. Then you can actually do some, get some insight, understanding what are actually the impact of the climate to the diseases. So this was our start in order to understand how can we actually support countries with data for decisions when it comes to diseases. But what we didn't know, the powerfulness, because this was kind of a pilot, and now 10 countries already have installed it, 4 in production, the rest in dev instances, to test it out, to do advocacy with health programs in order to learn, but also to see how can we work on this one. And we're also working on a predictive prediction platform to be able to do the same as we do with DHS2, because we see that all the models that are out there are pilotitis. It's pilots. It's hacks that you cannot learn from, that cannot scale, that we cannot even understand what we are testing and cannot travel from one country to another. So we are also working on making all these models available for countries to be tested out and to be utilized in predictions for diseases, where, whether they are climate sensitive or not, and also to see how, what can we do for intervention, can even assess interventions. So why are we doing all this? And why did Wellcome Trust come to us? They came to us because we are working with countries. Because it's so important for the countries then to collaborate with the Meteorological Institute, with the Environmental Institute, with the Ministry of Health, with the Mother and Child and Welfare, because nutrition is about social welfare. So we are doing super cross-sector in order to be able to understand, but also to deliver solutions in countries that can have impact. So we as a community, we are always moving to the not leaving anyone behind, because it's all about strong health systems. Because what is actually data about climate impact on health if we don't have strong health systems in the bottom? So we are still continue. We are working super hard on the strong, strengthening health information system. That's where NORAD came in, to continue this one, because that's the highest priority for NORAD and the Norwegian government, is strengthening health information systems. That's very good. But in addition, innovations on top, seeing how can we then learn about the climate changes in order to be able to prepare countries for what to come. So this climate health session will be held today in, at 2 o'clock or something, later today in Auditorium 1. Education will be on the morning session, but also in a education session for those of you interested in that one. And we will have very, very many parallel sessions. And as Max said, we are able to record it if we are not able to see all the things we are planning to. Oh. So this one is actually a bit of a teaser for the what's new in DHS2. This is the new extensibility project or product, we might say it is. It is about how do we do all these extensions on top of DHS2. Now I've been talking about these home extensions, that the climate health and education is more like what we're doing. But we are also looking for extensibility when it comes to other both sectors, but other vendors. And we are, of course, talking about logistics and health growth chart plugins and so forth. So this is it's not new, but now we are really working hard on see how can we do this in a more planned way in order to be able to strengthen the interface between the apps and the platform, so we can provide solid sustainability also for the app in the future. Because we really believe innovation in the fringes is the future for DHS2. DHS2 as a core cannot solve all the problems. However, we will hear a lot about all the problems the DHS2 platform can solve just after the short coffee break. Thank you. Since we have a very, very heavy program, so please be back here. It's a coffee and bio break. What's the time now?
Let's start 10 to 10. That's 20 minutes.
Yeah. 10 to 10? Back here 10 to 10. Then so we are having enough time to hear about what's new in DHS2. $9.50 is said in proper English. 10 to 10 is Norwegian, I think. So now go and get you, grab a coffee, go to the bio break and be back here at 9:15.